Stand by. I want to bring in right now Republican Senator James Lankford of Oklahoma. He's a key member of the Senate Intelligence Committee, also a member of the Homeland Security Committee. Senator, thanks so much for joining us.
With you, Wolf.
These individuals, high-ranking Russian officials working for the Russian military intelligence operation, directly, clearly, for the Russian government. Could this have been authorized by anyone other than President Vladimir Putin?
It could have been, but most likely it was authorized by him. So I can't imagine Putin not being engaged. Again, we lose track of the fact sometimes. He's a KGB agent, and what they always say is there is no former KGB agent. So he is somebody that's passionate about the intelligence, about going to be able to probe this. And so I can't imagine that he wasn't directly involved in this as well.
As you know, no Americans were indicted today, but you expect that to change?
I'm not sure that will change. They were pretty clear in the indictment today to be able to say there were Americans involved. We've known that for a while, even from the previous indictments against the Internet Research Agency, that was a Russian entity before when that came out, that it was clear that there were Americans they reached out to, that these were Russians, that was mentioned again today, that pretended to be Americans that were interacting with other Americans. So I think it's a big jump to say those Americans were colluding with, or they were cooperating with, or they may be indicted. These were Americans that were reached out to through different social media platforms by Russians that had pretended to also be Americans to be able to talk about the campaign. So they seem to be unwitting in this cooperation with some foreign entity.
In addition to going after the Democratic National Committee, the Democratic Congressional Campaign Committee, the Hillary Clinton campaign, the indictment makes it clear that the Russians also went after specific voting systems throughout the United States that are clearly vulnerable to hacking. And they say that 500,000 American citizens had very sensitive voter data information stolen. What is Congress doing to fix that?
Well, that's actually a bill that I've worked on. It's a bipartisan bill we released out months and months ago that we're working through the process right now. We just had a hearing with the Rules Committee this week on the Secure Elections Act. This is something Amy Klobuchar and I have worked on for months and months, along with Kamala Harris and multiple others. We believe that we should cooperate with the federal government and states in their election systems to make sure they stay secure. Now, elections are a state responsibility, and that's part of the strength of our system, is that there's such a diversity of systems. But if any one entity is vulnerable, then the entire election system is vulnerable. So we got to have more communication.
Yeah, go ahead, finish your thought.
Well, I was about to say, we got to have more communication, we've got to have better security, and we've got to be able to make sure that when we find out a threat is happening, that we're working with those states to be able to identify that threat and neutralize it.
You released a statement today, a very carefully written statement. I read it completely. It says in part, and let me quote from the statement, "With each passing month, our Russia investigations continue to confirm that Russian officials attempted to interfere in our 2016 election." Now, the Russians, clearly, according to this indictment, they hacked the DNC server, they hacked voter rolls, they hacked the Hillary Clinton campaign chairman. Isn't that more than an attempt?
Well, when you talk about that they interfered in our election, I think a lot of people take the next jump and say they changed votes, they changed the outcome. What's been very clear, both from all our DOJ, from Mueller, from all the way through the investigation, through both the House and the Senate, in a bipartisan agreement, we've not found evidence that they changed any votes, that they engaged in this, but clearly they were trying to be able to affect our elections. But we've got to be able to keep it clear. Because they were trying to be able to attack voting systems and try to find out more about them, they were probing that information. There are 21 plus states that we already know and have verifiable evidence that they were probing those different states to see if they can find that information. But most of those they were not able to get into. Some they were able to get to voter rolls, but not actually get to changing votes. So they were trying to find ways to engage. But again, we found no evidence, and so far we've seen nothing from the special counsel that they had changed votes, but they were clearly trying to engage our election to influence Americans.
Because they released a lot of emails throughout the course of that campaign that clearly potentially could have had a very, very serious effect. They weren't attempting to interfere. They clearly did interfere.
Well, they were engaged in it, and if you realize early on in the campaign, they were trying to affect every campaign. They were breeding chaos in it. The longer the campaign went on, and once it was two candidates, Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton, they were very focused in on doing everything they can to hurt Hillary Clinton. I think that's a key reason that they were going after the DNC to be able to get information there. It's a key reason that they were trying to be able to attack. They had a clear disdain for Hillary Clinton throughout the process.
The White House released a statement following the indictment. Let me read it to you in part. "Today's charges include no allegations of knowing involvement by anyone on the campaign and no allegations that the alleged hacking affected the election result. This is consistent with what we have been saying all along. The statement did not condemn the Russians for their activity, and that was surprising. I want you to compare what the White House statement said with what was just released by Senator John McCain. He says this: today's indictment is a result of the hard work of America's law enforcement and intelligence officials who dedicate their lives to bringing to justice those who wish to do us harm. These revelations add to a body of evidence confirming an extensive plot by Vladimir Putin's government to attack the 2016 election, sow chaos and dissension among the American electorate, and undermine faith in our democracy. If President Trump is not prepared to hold Putin accountable, the summit in Helsinki should not move forward. That statement from John McCain. Which of those two statements resonates more with you?
I would say McCain's statement does. It's very, very clear on it. I mean, what the president stated is also correct. But I'm proud that John McCain put out such a clear statement along those lines as well. There have been some actions on Russia of late, and what we saw previously when Mueller came out and indicted all those with the Internet Research Agency, there were sanctions that were laid on those individuals, whether it be some of the oligarchs that were involved in funding it, the individuals at the Internet Research Agency, the agency itself, and some of the intelligence bureaus within the Russian government. I would hope and expect that they would do that again and expand this out after the Mueller indictment to be able to expand out our sanctions. The president's been very clear with Germany and his frustration of their cooperation with Russia for Russian gas. That undermines NATO, that undermines all of Europe, for them to be able to get Russian gas and be dependent on Russia. And the president's been very outspoken on that to be able to push back on Russia with Germany. And I would hope he continues to press in other ways as well.
Should the president have said what Senator McCain said?
I would hope the president would continue to say some of those same things. He's affirmed law enforcement over and over again. He's been very frustrated. That's been very public about his frustration to say this seems to be a continual attack on him. But they find lots of evidence that the Russians were trying to engage. They're not finding evidence that that anyone on the president's campaign or the president himself were trying to work with the Russians. So these constant accusations that the president was somehow colluding with the Russians is very different than the Russians were trying to attack our system. No question the Russians were trying to attack. But I think the president frustrated there when immediately makes the next jump when there's no evidence for that.
The investigation, though, that Mueller has undertaken and his team obviously continues. Do you believe, in light of the indictment today, the president should cancel his planned summit Monday with Putin?
I don't. I think there are a lot of issues that have to be addressed, including this one. I think the president should be very frank on what he's already said about Ukraine. We have Russian engagement and occupation of eastern Ukraine. The president's already made a statement saying that's the first thing that's going to come up. We have to be able to deal with that. We've got to be able to deal with Syria. The Russians, I don't think, have much influence there. I think the Ayatollahs in Iran have been playing the Russians for a very long time and been basically using them as their own personal military for the things that Iran didn't want to do. But then Iran plans to stay, and the Russians are going to continue to be able to pull out. The United States and the Russians have to be able to talk about what happens in Syria and where does this go in the days ahead, because that's exceptionally important to the entire region. And I would certainly hope the president's very frank and clear to not believe President Putin when he says we didn't do it, and to know that we absolutely know that the Russians and President Putin were engaged in trying to affect our elections. And I hope the president will make that very blunt and clear.
Well, he keeps calling it a rigged witch hunt as recently as only a few hours ago, even though he knew what Rosenstein was about to announce. Senator Lankford, thanks so much for joining us.
You bet. Thank you.
Coming up, more details.